students, today I would like to discuss about sexual reproduction in flowering plants. Flower is meant for sexual reproduction. It consists of mainly four parts: calyx, corolla, androecium and gynoecium. Calyx and corolla are known as accessory organs because they do not take part in reproduction. Androecium and gynoecium are reproductive organs which take part in reproduction. Androecium is known as male reproductive organ and its unit is known as stamen. Gynoecium is known as female reproductive organ and its unit is known as carpel. Now I am going to discuss about development of male gametophyte. It means formation of male gamete. Sexual reproduction, as I told you in previous class, sexual reproduction is such type of reproduction which occurs by the formation and fusion of gametes. Here I shall discuss about the development of male gametophyte. It means formation of male gamete. As I told you, stamen, androecium is known as male reproductive organ and its unit is known as stamen. Stamen consists of three parts. Upper swollen knob-like part is known as anther, and thread-like part, this part is known as filament, and anther is bilobe. It means it consists of two chambers, both are connected with connective. This part is known as connective, which connects the two lobes of anther. Anther is the upper part of stamen and it forms male gamete. Here it is the enlarged diagram of anther. Anther is usually bilobed, so it is known as bithecus. It means it consists of two lobes, two chambers. As you see in the diagram, when it is cut, you can see two lobes, first lobe, second lobe, and each lobe contains two circular longitudinal sac-like structure known as microsporangium. This, it means each lobe contains two microsporangium, two lobe contain four microsporangium. Here it is the section of anther. You can see in the diagram the microsporangium consists of four layers. Outer layer is known as epidermis and second layer is known as endothecium and third layer, two or three layers, middle layers, and innermost layer is known as tapetum. Tapetum provides nourishment to the microspore mother cell. its next function is it secretes enzymes or hormones. It also helps in the formation of exine. What is exine? Exine is the outermost layer of microspore, which protects the microspore. Now we see that there are four microsporangium. They are located in each corner of interface. Each lobe contains two longitudinal sacs known as microsporangium. This microsporangium, this and this. This structure is known as vascular strength, which helps in transportation. Microsporangium contains sporogenous cells. These cells are diploid cells. It means it contains two sets of chromosomes. Now I shall discuss about the formation of male gametes. Sporogenous cell undergoes mitotic division and form microspore mother cell. Here microspore mother cell, it is also known as MMC. Or this cell is known as sporogenous cell. It is diploid cell. Here you can write mitotic division. A sporogenous cell undergoes mitotic division and forms a diploid cell known as microspore mother cell. Microspore mother cell undergoes meiotic division. Meiotic division and forms four microspore known as tetrad. Tetra means four, so it is known as tetrad. Here we take one cell known as microspore. It is formed by the process of meiosis, so it is haploid cell. You can write N. This can be written 2M. Now it is surrounded by the nucleus of microspore, divides in two unequal cells by mitosis, like this. This two cell stage is known as male gametophyte. This cell is known as vegetative cell, and this smaller cell is known as generative cell. Generative cell. It is surrounded by two layers. Outer layer is thick and known as epigyne, and inner layer is known as intyme. Epigyne is made up of a resistant substance known as sporopolenin, and inner layer intyme is made up of cellulose. Vegetative cell provides nourishment to generative cell. This epigyne contains a pore known as generative pore. Generative pore through which pollen tube develops like this. Pollen tube develops through generative pore. Generative cell moves down and later on divides to form two male gametes. This is known as pollen tube. Pollen germination takes place when it falls on the stigma of pistil. Now the development of male gametophyte is finished. These two cell condition is known as male gametophyte. In next class I shall discuss about the development of female gametophyte. If you like my class or video, please subscribe it. Thank you.